deal with it, even though they dealt with it very well last game. I kind of agree on that. I don't really have an issue with the Olaf ban coming out. It takes away potential flex picks as well.
So, for Vitality, they're back to the drawing board a little bit more. We heard from them in previous weeks that they were lacking some of that coordination. We're thinking with Shook back in the lineup, that might start to return. It is looking better, but it's not quite there yet. Trundle banned away now, and our favorite Taliyah ban. Vitality consistently hitting that one.
Does this mean Sion gets through? Because we're in a situation where you either have to ban away the Nidalee from Trashy, or you ban away the Sion, and maybe we'll see whether it was all a placebo effect after all.
Well, Vitality are clearly tunneling on something. And speaking of tunnels, I feel like Trashy can just go ahead and pick the Rek'Sai again anyways, because obviously you don't want to give Shook the Nidalee. But he just never looks as comfortable when he's on these more parry-oriented ones. And there's the Nidalee ban. And that's going to prompt a very quick first pick, Irelia for Wonder.
So Irelia, while Trundle is down, Olaf is down. So we would expect Shen to come through. There are other picks that you can play into Irelia that will kind of neutralize him more than anything and contain Malphite. But then it's Cabo Shard, so I don't really feel like that's the route he's going to go. I know for a while he was talking about how he's not the biggest of fans of some of the carries in the top lane. Weirdly for Cabo, but I wonder. I mean, he can't really go the Kennen route. It's not the best of picks into Irelia either. So I wonder which route Cabo is going to go now on the matchup.
Yeah, that's always the question mark. You can never really count Cabo out in a lot of situations because he's just a guy that brings so much diversity to the top lane matchup. And we've seen him cycling through some of his favorites too.
Could go the Hecarim route.
Yeah.
Was an old matchup into Irelia, not quite so good anymore after the Hecarim passive change, but yeah,
we don't find out now. It's going to be the Karma lock, and it's going to be Shook taking Gragas. He's put himself on a tank jungle. It does give him a lot of team fighting and disengage.
Is this it? Are we seeing Sion Jin come out here? Is that the flavor of the cheese that's coming? A very difficult lane to cope with. You can see Senkux at least is playing around a little bit. After so many Sion bans for the last three games, it's been banned every single time.
I mean, clearly these teams know something about Splice right now.
Mickey's just going to pick Bard and be like, yeah, I was never going to play Sion anyway.
It was all a deception, an elaborate ruse. I mean, Mickey's Bard has been...
Is what's happening.
Mickey's Bard has been really, really... Yeah, I'm not even sarcastic. He's going to lock it in. We've got a Cave Bard comp. Oh, man, the highlight reel is going to go nuts.
Pretty much everybody, although I guess yesterday Splice, it wasn't like... The bans undid them that much, but everybody that's now banned Sion is kind of face-palming a little bit. And it's like, ah, oh, we wasted a ban, maybe. But anything like that is always better to not play against it than risk getting cheesed out by it.
Maybe one day we will see the Sion support, but that is not this day. Instead, we get graced with the presence of Mickey's Bard.
I wouldn't mind also seeing the Ashe come out from Police here either. He's played it a couple of times. Has been a pretty good pick for him, and gives Vitality an engage tool if they want to go that route. Although they do have Gragas, can be the disengage, could also be top lane as well, as we're looking perhaps.
Yes.
Can play it into the Irelia. It's kind of a pick that is ultimately going to end up losing out to Irelia. You can kind of maintain a laning phase against her. Some sense of wave clear, some sense of ability to hold her, but it's not over the top.
You never know, man. Jungle Sion, come on, let's see it. By the way, while we're still ticking down the clock, I've just been told that over on the other stream, Sven actually shattered Reckless's CS record. That game is still going.
That game is still going.
Yeah, it's happening.
What?
So dual streams for the win, guys.
What?
Yeah, that happened.
Okay, I'm at a loss for words. And
we have to cast this game, though, Stress.
I know, but I'm a little disappointed to hear that, I must admit. There has been a lot of talk about, was an 80-minute game good or was it bad? I'm probably not on the hype train of multi-80-minute games.
Clearly, Origin know how to play long games. But dialing back in on this one as the timer ticks down, seeing the Elise, it can be tanky, but it's kind of like we've seen junglers almost switch a little bit on their priority this game.
But here's the thing of what Splice have to go alongside it. They have a Bard who is very good at setting up the fights initially. So now you've got the Bard, you've got the Elise.
Oh, they've got so many ways to just eliminate somebody.
Exactly. You Bard ult into K-Trap, anything like that that you can close the distance on.
Now the question is, do you like Zillion combined with this, the Death Denial?
that they've run so many times.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen the Zilean, but then it's Kasing, and you realize that he hovers Zilean every game.
That's
anyway.
True, but like, it's a legit thing here, is what I mean.
It is. We could also see the Karma go into the mid lane right now against Azir is not the worst of matchups, and then end up getting another support to go alongside the Jhin. Maybe Kasing will play the Sion. That would be the ultimate irony. But Kasing's more of a player that tends towards picks like Thresh with a Jhin, if he is going support here. Morgana fits well. Single
okay.
target protection.
And this is a Kasing comfort pick as well, from going further back.
Yeah, it's a pick that Kasing has been known for in the past, but I never would have said it was his absolute tip-top champion. He's always tended more towards Thresh. So it gives them catch potential, gives them another Black Shield onto Jhin. You've got a second utility-style champion with the Morg, with the Karma here. Disengage going to come from Gragas as well. So Vitality are playing a little bit more around the delay fights, force Splice to put Peel back away. And now you can maybe utilize some of that Jhin damage coming from yourself.
Very possibly. We'll have to see how it all shakes out. It's kind of nice to see a little bit of things mixed up here in picks and bans. And I'll see what Shook makes out of the Rek'Sai. There's a lot of damage on the side, a lot of single target especially, over on the side of Splice. But for Vitality, it's going to be all about keeping that backline safe, keeping Police in a comfortable position. Seeing if that's going to be enough to get them a victory here.
Yeah, see if we can keep him safe for long enough.
Will there be the sirens going off, either way. All right, well, why don't you guys at home keep telling us what you think is going to happen here. Is Splice going to knock another one out of the park here, pick up a 2-0 on the day? If you think so, hashtag SPYWin. Will this pick comp do enough to take the victory? Or if Vitality is going to claw their way back and get themselves another 1-1. V-I-T win, V for victory in that case. As the teams are loading up to get onto the Rift. Game number two here in this series. Splice looking to crawl up those standings a little bit higher. Every point matters in this game, and we're onto the Rift.
And here is where one benefit of the Morgana pick may very well shine through. You cannot bard ult a Black Shielded target.
Ooh.
So.
That's gonna be interesting.
If he hits that on Police, it's not gonna have any effect. If the Black Shield misses, then...
I mean, if they get everybody else, though, then you just run.
Oh, yeah, you get everybody else. But the whole thing we've been seeing with a lot of bards up against Jhin is as soon as Jhin ults, you pop the bard ult on him, stop the ult, stop the damage, lock him down.
All right. Unfortunately, Kasing does tank a binding, a cosmic binding. The first casualty is his health bar. Looks like we are in for the standard lane so far. I may be speaking a little bit too soon, though, because... there's some wandering up towards the top, Vitality. Kasing and Police are actually going up that way, and we do see the Swaparoo. There's pings flying from Splice, and it looks like they're gonna sniff this out.
But that is what Vitality's prerogative is gonna be here. They do not want the 2v2. Caitlyn Bard do not want to trade into that at any point, whereas
yeah,
Splice
that's...
are gonna try and sniff it out, chase themselves the 2v2, end up with Australia lanes. G'day.
Hi, how are you?
The most American response to g'day ever.
All right, so with Wonder down on the bottom side, Kaba Shard will be dealing with him, but we have the double jungle for the time being, and with Ooh. Australia lanes, there won't be any fast pushes.
But because Splice haven't really seen anything, there is going to be a push onto the wave from Vitality here. Look, Splice were out of the wave, and they're going to get zoned back a little bit for the first couple of minions. I wonder how that's going to get evened down. You can see Kasing didn't take Tormented Soil to push at all. He has got the Dark Binding, and... there's the Piltover Peacemaker, actually turns this back in the favor. It's an even start to this, but there is more damage on the ranged minions Ooh. Here. Mickey takes a big trade. Good trade from Vitality already.
That's such a long duration on the Dark Binding, and it's the kind of thing, since you don't see it all the time in competitive, that you can underestimate how much you can actually get back out of that.
Oh,
but Police, he does get stunned too. There's a binding left and right now. Police a little bit low. He might have to start chugging on the potions, or rather eating the biscuits, and he does indeed. Farm traded, but a lot of damage as well. Back to the mid lane, it's the Karma versus Azir. A lot of poke in this matchup. Nuke Duck stepping left and right to dodge it out. We do see a lot more of the Karma in the support role these days, but it can, of course, always be the mid lane.
Yeah, it's a fine matchup into Azir. Karma very rarely is ever going to have kill pressure on anybody, and it's very rare that somebody's going to have kill pressure on her. So she kind of just sits there for a while, holds the Azir in place, and you just farm up, especially in standard lanes. We'll see whether there is jungler pressure coming around here. both junglers are hovering around mid on the top side. So maybe we'll get a gank.
And for Trashy, though he's typically fallen into a much more teamfight-oriented jungler, he's definitely on an early game pressure champ right now, picking up this Elise. Seeing how he performs on it will be something we want to keep our eyes on throughout the entire game here, looking ahead.
Yeah, we'll keep our eyes on that as it goes. You can see the 2v2 somewhat even right now. You can see Vitality had a bit of a good start, at least to the trading in the lane, but then it got evened up by the push advantage. And now Vitality are shoving out with that Tormented Soil, with the fact that they can just bounce the grenade and push through the wave. But as soon as they end up in a situation where Splice feel confident enough to trade, they're one Cosmic Binding and a trap away from pretty much losing a Flash, losing a Summoner. You've always got to be careful about that. But the same can be said the other side, is Morgana can proc the W from Jhin very easily using Tormented Soil, and then you Dark Binding. Heavy, heavy crowd control dual lanes here. You can see, look, they're already looking for it. Mickey gets tagged. If that had been the W coming out, would have been a good trade, but Kasing Black Shields the crowd control on his own way. Very meticulous trading back and forth here in this 2v2.
Yeah, meanwhile, back in the mid, Nuketuk's trying to zone Senkuk's off the farm. He does take a few shots from a soldier, but yeah, a really good trade for him. And, you know, with all of that said and done, the bottom lane, or rather what was the top lane in this Australia setup, is kind of the much more quiet out of it all, but Trashy still hanging around there. Not going to be able to find anything, though. Kabuchard had actually backed away. The junglers might even find each other here. Shook is going to sense out Trashy's presence as he attempts to take out the Scuttle Crab. In will come Nuketuk, the rappel, to try and dodge, but the leash is on. Senkux is here for the defense. Try and turn it around a little bit. Explosive Spiderling. He'll make Nuketuk rethink his aggression twice.
Spots that Nuketuk had low mana, couldn't really afford to all in on that. Otherwise, he would risk Senkux turning it back around, having that exhaust. So, results in nothing really coming from that. But Shook is able to pull him back away from the crab, assume control of that dragon. It is Mountain Drake to begin this off, so there is a little higher importance perhaps than the Cloud Drakes we've seen. And here comes the TP advantage of playing like the Karma into the Azir. You know Azir cannot really take TP unless apparently he's Power of Evil, but in goes Azir on.
Oh, and they find a lot of damage. The cocoon was hitting, exhaust is on. This should be first blood here in Trashy. The flash away, Nuketuk, he might just get out of this yet, but is it
shield
going to be enough? The shield's there, and they turn it around. In comes Shook for first blood.
Oh, Trashy, oh, hang on, lockdown top lane.
Yeah, police a little low. They did have the dark, or the black shield, I should say, on there. Wow, Shook just out of the shadows, and he gets himself the first kill, man. And that's with a Sightstone Rek'Sai, by the way. Not a whole lot of battle stats there.
It was a nice setup. We'll see if there's another good setup, but the flash is still available for Senkux, despite the fact that he doesn't have to use it in that exchange. It looked to be good for Splice. They were about to punish Nuketuk coming back to the middle lane using his TP as we once again see trading topside. But the reason that they couldn't convert it is because Trashy rappels up before the flash of Nuketuk was actually used. So the rappel down is easily choreographed. Nuketuk flashes out, gets himself away. Shook comes in from the side to, you know, make sure they pick up the kill. And Trashy had to use his flash too. Big, big misread on the situation from Trashy.
And this is just showing how, you know, uncomfortable Trashy is in these kind of situations. He doesn't usually get these big ganks off early on these early pressure champs. I mean, he nailed a cocoon, sure, it looked like it was gonna be the kill. That was point blank. You know, everybody's gotta be able to do that, but you know, taking a look at it again, it seems so easy, but they went away empty-handed.
Yeah, I mean, the thing here is Senkux again on low mana, so the follow-up from Senkux is very limited. At this point, Senkux should just chase him down, auto him, and then Trashy can meet him in the middle. And at that point, Nuketuk has to flash past, and you still have the auto-attack range on it. All you need is like one Q in spider form and you can actually take that kill. But utilizing the repel, flash, not the best.
Mickey, he only took one shot of the tower, but he's playing really aggressively on this Bard and eating Dark Bindings in all honesty. Kabuchard's gonna get found by Trashy, it's a 2v1! But the big barrel comes out to push him away, he saves his own life.
Getting denied heavily right now is Trashy on these plays that he's trying to make. He's behind on levels now, is somewhat behind on farm, and has lost out on this. Here comes Shook back into his own jungle looking for the river. And honestly, this is a lot better from Vitality. Although, I guess you could say game one had a good start for them. Wonder kind of suiciding himself into Cabo's Olaf in game one. Hasn't quite happened the same way in game two.
It's definitely been a much more quiet affair between the solo laners. Jungler's getting involved in the bottom side now. Wonder is a little bit low. The Transcendent Blades come out to clear the wave, but lying in wait is Shook, and
He gets spotted.
Yeah, Ward comes out from Wonder.
Oh, but they're going for it.
Cabo's no ult.
All right.
That's the big thing there. If Cabo had been able to blast Wonder away from the tower, maybe there was a gank on, but Shook was already backing away.
Yeah. Wonder's been doing pretty solid on the Sorrelia, building up the CS lead, and all he needs to do is wait until he hits his Trinity Force power spike to really start do some work. In the top lane, duo laners continue to trade back and forth, but for Police, it's all about staying alive and trying to dish out as much aggression and poke as they can onto Kabi and Mickey, a very rough lane for them to deal with.
And that's the thing, is like Police's impact in this game is going to come at a different point to Kabi. Kabi is expected to be ahead right now. But it's only when we get to team fights that Police is going to be able to really lay down the law, get into that curtain call, fire out the shots, get the multiple, you know, potential kills that come out from that. But again, that's where Caitlyn's going to struggle, because if she can't really get the autos down, doesn't have two and a half, three items at that point, you end up falling behind the curve. Mason Hall comes out just to damage Police, force him back away from this. Try and expand the minion lead, or the CS lead, between the two for now.
Yeah, Mickey and Kabi have really been making Police's life hard, but as you mentioned, it's not his time to shine just yet, and it's going to be a very close game. The gold is dead on even right now. No towers taken because there haven't been any big power plays. We talked about Trashy being kind of a neutralizing jungler, but it's been Shook who's neutralized his attempts, and Kabochard, who's also really denied some of this on the bottom side as well, and you know, he's been able to hold his own. Perfectly happy with it, and they've just, you know, kind of moved him into a different role this game on the Grog. He's much more utilitarian.
And we've seen it from Kabochard a few times throughout this season. The Gragas is just a pick that he can use fairly effectively. Has that right mix for him of damage and tankiness. Can get himself in the fights. Going the full tank route, we have started to see a couple of Gragas in Challenger a little bit start going slightly heavier towards the AP route. But the same way we're kind of seeing Echo do that, but it fell off in the end of all things. So for Kabochard and the rest of Vitality, we'll see how they can make that work for themselves with that disengage in fights, trying to protect the Police.
Yeah. But with what Splice have built, too, they have so much pick potential if they can grab a quick target. If they grab Police, I mean, Vitality just do not have nearly enough damage on the back of it. Nuke Duck might be an alternative target. Kasing squishy, too, but you know, all that damage coming
from the source
is Shook. He's waiting around. There's a point-blank binding into the chains. Mickey, he's got a journey in front of him, but he can't quite take it as Police gets the kill. Shook coming around the backside. I don't think he even wanted it. As Kabi took a few pot shots at him, the heal wasn't even enough to save Mickey's life.
He just wanted to be a penguin for a moment, going through the magical journey. Oh, Nuke Tuck.
Oh!
Oh, that was a...
That's when you change your mind halfway through the shuffle.
Yeah, that looked weirder than I think it was meant to. But at that point, it was a nice little dodge out from Senkux. So it turns out that it might not be just Kabochard being in the top lane. Shook just loves going top. It doesn't matter who's up there, what's going on, just send Shook up there, we'll get something from it. This time it's a kill onto Mickey.
Yeah, and it's gonna net them a tower as well. 11 minutes in, and we start to see the objectives going over Vitality's way. They will have this lead here. Splice, you know, they managed to get one last game. The flash, the follow-up here, Nuke Duck. That's gonna be Trashy looking to chase him down. Do they have enough? They do! Soldiers finish the job for Senkux.
This time the flash had already come out. It was an easy pickup. There was no real worry about him getting away. So take a look at the bottom lane. Ooh, hang on, Cabo Wonder.
Oh, Cabo, he's holding the barrel. It's coming out. Wonder can't catch him. And the Fat Man makes his escape again.
So we were talking about how it would potentially be an okay lane matchup, but ends up getting worse for Gragas. Already, there's nearly a 30 CS lead for Wonder. Just crested that point right now, so Cabo is struggling there, and you can see the amount of damage that was that they were able to put down.
Yeah, he's got a level disadvantage too. I mean, he's having a hard time, but his job is to survive right now.
Yeah, his job is to survive. He was set on just under 1,000 gold, but then Wonder was set on 1,300, so it's not even like there was too big a difference. Now when we look at it, though, it's Sunfire Cape to makings of a Triforce, so maybe Cabo will be a little better off in that exchange.
Yeah, there'll be a little bit of time before Wonder can really start to push up and punish him a little bit more. What? Take a look at what these two junglers are still doing, because Shook is still trying to be aggressive and stop Trashy from getting anything done. He does have backup here, but so does Trashy. Mickey now, he goes down. The Tempered Fate is thrown. Can they get the catch on? They don't connect on everything, but they do have enough to really punish him. The Black Shield does come out, however, and it prevents any more CC from landing, and Shook is able to survive.
Yeah, there was a lot of defensive crowd control used that by Vitality there to secure the livelihood of Shook. Heavy trade happening in the bottom lane. Yeah. Look at the health bar of Cabo Shard just shredded down. But it doesn't result in a kill, but that's what Wonder wants to do, is he's going to trade like that when he knows there's no ult available from Cabo. Cabo's ult only just coming up now. So picking a good spot for that trade using his Transcendent Blades.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for Cabo for still some time, but they're banking on the fact that they can win the team fights. Police, the man that they're going to pin their hopes and dreams on here, has himself a Ghost Blade now, working his way further and further. And, you know, his power will wax a little bit more as Kabi's wanes, but, you know, still only 13 minutes in this game. The lanes are still there, even though there was a tower taken by Vitality. So we still got some time before we start getting into those mid games and the skirmishes that'll follow. Moundrake hasn't been touched, by the way.
Nope.
No team's had an opening for this. So even though it's approaching Cloudrake levels of relevance, it can be taken anytime soon.
Vitality kept their dual lane top, so despite having an advantage, haven't really wanted to go and take down the Mountain Drake. Sadly, no real comparison to like Articuno, Moltres. It's the odd one out, I guess, at that point.
Well, it's just kind of weird elementally.
Yeah.
How can a dragon made out of a mountain fly?
That's what I was trying to think of, a good comparison. I'm sure there is one somewhere.
I mean, at this point, I've lost track of all the new Pokemon, so I'm assuming there probably is a ground flying type.
There was an ice cream and a candle.
And a washing machine.
So I don't know. There was a washing machine?
Yeah, Nintendo's getting weird, man.
Okay. I mean, I guess when you get over like 700, it does get a little crazy.
You kind of start to run out of ideas.
I guess the same could be said when you get over 700 CS in a game of League, right?
I know you're still over that one. Wonder's going to have to be getting out of here. And Shook is coming in hot on his tail. That's going to be Wonder backing off. The flash burned already. They can't take the tower, though, just yet, because there's still no minion wave. However, Vitality, they're throwing their weight around, quite literally in Kabushard's case.
And Splice right now, they're just going to be content with pushing the top side. They know they'll lose Mountain Drake after this, so they're not going to be able to continue this push. It's going to be tower for tower and Drake. And depending on whether Vitality call their bluff on that and look to push for the second tier, I don't really think they'll be able to. Aurelia's there. Bard has his ultimate available to defend against this. And Shook is starting to make his way bottom lane. It's a long way away, but the defense play for the Bard ult is available.
Yeah,
and here it comes.
Gonna land. Okay, they just dodge it, but they can't take out the tower. This is going to mean we turn and take out the Mountain Drake, which Trashy's here. I almost said Shook. I'm like, oh yeah, Shook's on the Elise. That makes sense.
But that's the thing, is maybe Vitality should have prioritized Mountain Drake instead of the push there, because yes, it takes a while to take, but
so does tower.
Right now they have to back themselves away. And that's the thing, is they were never going to take that tower. Because of the way Splice only has two people committed to topside anyway, Splice can always regroup around that bottom side tower and defend the play. So Vitality perhaps just lost out on an objective advantage, and they've now just conceded the room for Splice.
They did concede Mickey, though. He's going to be in some trouble. Magical Journey chains. He's out of it. Still a lot spent there. Vitality, Trashy wants to fight this one out, but he's taking a lot of damage. Okay. Splice, aggressively defend the territory that they earned here over by the Dragon Pit.
Now Splice are going to push out bottom side, and they're going to be able to perhaps even up the towers. I wonder.
He did get the blue trinket, though.
It delays the recall, which actually, now when you look at how this is pushing up, gives Cabo Shard some extra safety. Because it means for at least another 10 seconds, or at least half of this wave, there's no way of Wonder and Trashy collapsing on him. You can see where Trashy is right now on the map. Imagine if Wonder was at the same spot, Cabo Shard would perhaps have had to have readjusted where he was. Couldn't really have afforded to, because actually Wonder would have been going a little faster out of the base. Gives Vitality, now that they've got the information on topside, a chance to take down this Mountain Drake. So ultimately, they don't end up losing too much out of it.
Yeah. At the end of the day, kind of things traded back and forth, and we settle into a little bit more normalcy as Vitality get themselves the first dragon. 17 minutes, though, it is a bit odd with the way this game played out in the early game. Splice on their side are going to alternatively trade over for the Rift Tail. Should give that one to Wonder and give him the pushing power against Cabo Shard.
And if you look at this objective trade in a vacuum, I would argue that the Rift Herald going to Wonder is going to be more significant for the team composition of Splice than the Mountain Drake is going to be for Vitality. Yes, Vitality will now have obviously the added pressure on Baron, the presence from all that good stuff in the towers, but Wonder needs to become unstoppable. They need a situation where nobody can sit in a side lane, and he's already getting there from the lead that he has against Cabo Shard, so it just kind of compounds it and makes it even better for Splice.
Yeah, you know it's a strange game when Mountain Drake isn't worth as much as Rift Herald.
Well, as I said, if you look at it in a vacuum alone, if you look at it in that exact trade, I still think Mountain Drake is very useful just in all scenarios. But certainly Wonder will be happy to have that Rift Herald himself. Trashy.
Yeah, Dark Binding, that duration is real long here. And that chain, he's coming down. Kasing's going to have to flash away. Exhaust is on very quickly, and they still manage to catch him. In comes Mickey round the side, and we've got ourselves the makings of a real strange fight. Splice. Vitality.
Oh, they want to back away, though. Vitality still wants to fight, but Splice don't.
One member down, trying to still move their way forward. There's a big wave in the top side for Vitality, but they can't get anything else done on the mid. Gold still very close to even. Splice with a slight edge in this game at 18 minutes in. Vitality are trying to change that, though.
A lot of it is through farm as well. Look down the lanes. There's significantly top little lead mid and bottom lane. So a lot of it is just from that farming. Oh, hang on. Oh,
hey, they caught Mickey, and he can't even go through the own journey. That Goblin Shard finishes him off. Curtain Call comes in. Not required. It does get canceled.
Yeah, a lot of ults used got canceled, which puts it on a shorter cooldown than if he'd have fired the four shots, but still puts it on cooldown.
Yep.
Oh, Trashy misses another cocoon.
Yeah, Shook face checks, but he doesn't pay for it. That was a point blank for sure. Senkuk's trying to clear the way. Yeah, he's going
to
get hit by the binding now, and they've got everyone in there. Senkuk's melting away. The divide comes too late. And that's going to be another tower for Vitality.
And you can see how the crowd control is very easily layered. They've got a lot to set Jhin up for the W and get that lockdown, and Senkuk's can't get himself away. He had flash, but the first time that a piece of crowd control hits him, he's pretty much doomed.
Those Dark Bindings are really making the difference in a lot of these fights. So as we approach 20-minute mark in the game, starting to move further and further along in that mid, there's another tower knockdown for Vitality, 3-1 of Splice. The gold lead is theirs. But Splice are hot on their heels, trying to get a chase off. They managed to catch Nuke Duck. Tempered Fade, Tabi, everyone coming in. Quick Flash, Trashy is right behind him. He's trying to juke, but in comes Shook around the side. Can he stay alive under this tower? The answer is no, as Mickey finishes him off.
Nukta caught in that real tough range to escape a bad ultimate where you don't quite have enough time to react. This was Mickey getting picked off. Thought he was out. He was like, I've got this, guys, and then...
Have some Gatorade.
Yeah. Barrel into the wall. This doesn't even matter. Just gets hit by the splash pack at that point. It's like Alien gets caught by the acid comes from it. That's what actually gets the kill.
That was a weird transition, I'm not
yeah,
gonna lie.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I really like Alien, so I'll give you kudos for attempting it.
I mean, it's like the... Yeah, I'm gonna leave that.
That's okay.
It's a bit graphic, actually, yeah.
That was a good movie. Yeah. Okay, another binding, dodged out. Ocean Dragon's gonna be the next. Trashy, oh, he wants it, and he goes forward to get himself the cocoon. Kasing a little low in the back. Senkux has gone around. Shook can't hold the line here. Trashy takes him out. Curtain Call to try and soften them up. Trashy's really low. They're not touching him here. Senkuk will get the kill. The shots come flying, but there's no follow-up now. And Splice will grab themselves two for none.
Too high health for the Splice crew when Police hit that ultimate. Yes, he got Trashy very low, but it wasn't quite enough to take him out. No dragon available as we're 1 minute 40 away. Baron is up, but it's the opposite side of the map, so it was just a small push out from Splice to make sure they could kind of push bottom lane, get vision control of the lower side jungle, and then recall. But it's two picks that go over to Splice. It's a decent spot to be in. Still only a small lead maintained by Splice. So
yeah.
It is balancing on a knife's edge right now, really.
It's a very close game, all things considered. And you know, with the way the comps are kind of laid out here, it's hard to tell who's going to win it when it comes to later on in the game. I mean, there's a lot of damage on the side of Splice, but we've shown that Vitality, they can out-team fight as well. Just can't get caught. Can't afford to get caught. That's the real key for this team.
Shook is building magic resist right now, more than anything. He's stacking a whole lot of it. He's against a Caitlyn and an Irelia.
No, it's Mickey. It's Mickey he's worried about, man. Come on, let's be real.
He is also against an Elise and an Azir, so I will give him the benefit of the doubt on that. Just do want him to maybe transition to slightly different itemization coming next to maybe stop Cobby in his tracks.
Speaking of Trashy,
Shook's still fairly tanky at this point. You can see how long it really takes to chunk through him. And then Kasing, thought he was okay. Turns out, at the end of this, Ace and Hole comes through. Soldiers do their duty. I was going to say to God and to the Queen, but that's a very British thing to say at that point. So I guess wherever Shurima, I guess he's the Emperor. So.
Yeah, I mean, it's still a monarchy, right? It's just a different
very different kind. Something to tell me if the Queen of England would start like ordering people around like that, people might have a bit of a problem with it.
Well, you know, that's why my country had a bit of a problem.
that's true, actually. You got rid of our tea. Well, I still want that back.
I don't think you do. It's been in the Atlantic for a couple hundred years.
Uh-oh.
And Trashy's been in that binding for quite a long time, too. He's gone. That's going to be a teleport in. And Ooh. Mickey, he's just out of range. Shook, though, the rest of the team, they're chasing on. 5-5 is the kill score, but Vitality, they're looking
binding.
For more. Binding lands, and the Tempered Fate delays the inevitable from Mickey. There's been some highlight bard reels, but it's been for Vitality that have been way in the lead on this one. Tower falls at the end of it all, and now Vitality trying to decide where they move to next with Splice all in the mid lane.
You can see still Sengkux and Wonder available on this. Vitality have held off on the Baron until now. Trashy is just spawning. He's not going to be able to get there for a steal, but it is only 3 versus 5 here. I don't really fancy the odds from Splice here, safe from Sengkux coming in with a massive play. Kasing's gonna zone, Wonder goes in.
Yeah, tries to get the pick off, and it's not going to be enough. The Baron has been stopped, and Sengkux, he's gonna go down as he tries to go in for a massive shuffle here. Baron's gonna get taken out,
but in.
Wonder takes out Police. Can the Aurelia do it? It's going low, but Shook manages to get the smite away at the end,
the
and he
cleanup.
Dies. The cleanup crew is coming, though. Splice have managed to turn this around. They get a 1-for-3 even when the Baron goes over to Vitality.
And it's only Nukeduck and Kasing that escape. The saving grace, perhaps, of Vitality on that is Nukeduck is one of the TP users. But look at how Splice are going to answer. They've brought Trashy all the way up the mid lane already. 15 seconds at least on the recalls, or on the respawns, means Splice may very well crack the first inhibitor tower of the game here. Going to put the traps down, and that zones away Vitality from being able to defend against this properly.
Minions are gone, but they've got Spiderlings, so Splice just don't have any worries here in this game. Taking out the tower, jumping onto Kasing. Binding's there, but they just don't have anything else. In comes Police, and Mickey, he's going a little bit low. Can he dodge it out? One more shot, the magical tourney, and Police shuts him down in the midst of it. Vitality defend here. They have an open inhib, though, and they got damage control.
Damage control, but look, the Baron power play has been turned right away, right the way around here. Of course, it starts at plus 1500. That's the gold equivalent for taking Baron. Now it's at minus 500. Let's take another look at why. This was a setup onto Trashy, taken out instantly, and Mickey tries to get himself away in this exchange and doesn't quite end up successful as Cobby got away. I think that's really important here, is how Cobby is able to net away from Gragas, get himself the distance, and ultimately is able to turn it around from there. A long portion where Vitality are umming and ahhing. Do we want to take mid lane? Do we want to stop them? Do we want to come back for the Baron? Then they commit to it. And yes, it's not so important that they took quite so much time initially right here, but it's now the transition point after this that is a result of that. So Sengkux ends up dying, but look at the amount of damage he does already. This allows Cobby to come into the fight and start chunking people down. Unfortunately, there is no real way to secure that for Splice there. It would have been a real big misplay if Shook hadn't have been able to secure that Baron, as it was around 600 health. So we have just seen, though, a dragon go over to Vitality plus the tower going down as well.
So they still get something back for it, but they've lost some members with the Baron buff, so they're not going to have as effective of a Baron power play as it could have been for them. The kills have been evened up. It is 8-8. The gold is still incredibly close. This game, you said it balanced on a knife edge, and that's kind of been tilting back and forth in the entirety of this series. 26 minutes in, Vitality, they want to try to even this game up against Splice. Took them down in spectacular style at the end of a very, very quiet game, relatively speaking. It's been much more noisy this time around.
I've heard the tale of the boy who lived. Vitalities is the team of the team that ties the entire time. We'll see whether Shook and we'll see whether Shawn's lets him out of the cupboard under the stairs, perhaps to get a 2-0 at some point. Vitality really could do with a 2-0. Just for mentality's sake, I feel.
Yeah.
Because it's like,
well,
what do we
today,
have to do?
Unfortunately.
No, I know. But they must be thinking, what do we have to do
to
turn this around, turn our fortune?
They've just had so many troubles trying to get their team back on track. And, you know, Shook coming in, you've seen it's a little palpable here with the atmosphere changing. The way they've played seems a bit more decisive, but it just isn't enough right now. And they're also up against Splice, who are a team that is very much improved from the last split, that we are now considering a, you know, an upper middle table. It's hard to tell with everyone so close, but upper middle class, I don't know. But Splice are looking like a much better team overall, and it's definitely showing in this series.
We basically do have a pretty big divide in Europe. We've got like G2, Fnatic when they're not playing G2, and then everybody else is practically where we're at right now, looking at today's results. But even then, like we obviously won't spoil the result as well, but the Origin G2 series seems to be a lot closer.
I'm wondering if it's still going on. I don't know. Producers will tell us a little bit later. Splice, though, they're trying to get away here. Kasing flapping. Ooh. The binding will not connect. And Senkux throws up the Fun Disc, trying to push him away. Kabushar's still trying to chase, but he does not have any friends right now. There we are. They were at the back. Kasing, though, he's actually caught out for a second. That's fine. They don't have enough damage to finish him. And now the fight will re-engage Trashy. He's caught. He's the cool. Barrel. They've got him. Do they have the damage? He repels up, but he can't quite come down. Police will manage to finish the job. Trashy's gone, and now they're going to start pushing down the middle.
And Wonder Wave is trying to push off at the side. Here goes Cabo.
Fight's starting, but the Tempered Fate comes on, and that's going to stop it for just a few more seconds. And in
the binding.
Deer Soldiers, the binding. They're starting to melt through. Wonder around the side. Look at those health bars. Police, he's screaming for backup, but nobody's there. And Wonder is wrecking through this team. Oh, Splice come up huge.
We showed the highlight reel for Mickey yesterday. Add another one on it. Gets the double binding off the backside of the Tempered Fate. Sets Splice up to allow Wonder to come back into the fight, and everything goes Splice's way. It's been back and forth for a while. Still 30 seconds on Nukeduck. It's only Shook here. He's gonna get picked off. Shook is on his own. Splice umming and ahhing about ending the game, though.
Yeah, onto the Nexus turrets they go. Shook was just trying to look tasty for himself, but now the Emperor's Divide pushing him back. The Nexus turrets are going to fall. Shook is trying to interrupt. Don't even fight. Just go for the Nexus. Splice, they're looking for the 2-0, and they will do it! GG! Two games, and it comes down to a single fight in both of them. Splice picking up a 2-0 on the day. And that is a big, decisive result for them.
2-0
Vitality coming up short.
Splice showing us they are the perhaps the stronger favored yellow color team right now. With the we had the battle of see who would be able to take that.
Yes, who is stronger? Color. Bright yellow or beige yellow?
Exactly, snakes or bees.
Yeah,
at
well,
that point.
I think if you're going on biology, snakes should be stronger. In this case, they definitely were. I don't know where I'm going with this, but yeah, Splice came up very, very powerful when it counted, and you can see it on Shook's face. Very disappointing for all the effort he put in there. Just couldn't get the team far enough ahead, and Splice, we talked about them becoming more powerful, looking better together, and those are the fights you have to win to finish the games, and they did it not once, but twice today.
Yeah, and Splice showed us a
something weird. Is that what they showed us?
Team spirit.
Yeah.
Is where I guess we'll go on that one.
All right. Yamato is he's beaming at this point, and
that's a Yamato gift.
That's definitely going to go down somewhere on the internet, that's for sure.
Oh, I don't want to know where, but what I do want to know is where Mickey can pull those bot ultimate.
You have to ban this champion from him.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't like he nailed, he didn't just have like these golden ults every single time, but when it counted, that made such a big difference. And the follow-up, he had the double bindings constantly. He made the most out of this champion. And on a champion like Bard, where you can make these big plays, and it really just comes down to the individual skill of the player to set things up for his team, he does it more often than not.
And that's the thing, is like, I look at the bans, I look at the Talia ban, and is it like the Sion ban, where every other team's done it just because they're afraid that everybody's banning it, so now, do we ban Talia? Well, I guess we let the Bard through, and suddenly, oh, Mickey showed us that he's good on
yeah.
Bard already?
Splice is a team that's got a lot of mysteries for sure, and teams are having a hard time figuring them out. Let's go a little bit further back into that game and take a look at how a lot of things happened. The mid lane fight, 29 minutes in, you know, this proved fairly decisive. Big belly bop from Kabushard, and there was a beautiful Bard ult.
Here comes the double binding into Senkux with two soldiers seeing double at that point. It's a good fight.
Yeah.
Splice.
I mean, Wonder also gets the cleanup crew in the back, but the problem was Vitality just scattered at that point.
Yeah, I mean, Wonder's on Irelia, so that's an Irelia's dream, is that you've got two targets that have been locked down just under like a Sun Disk, and suddenly they have no way of retreating out of that situation. So, I mean, great team fight for Splice after a rocky start.
Yeah, excellent play from them and a well-earned 2-0. Now let's go ahead and send it down to Pulse. He's standing by with Wonder. We'll hear a little bit more about that game.
Thank you very much, guys. And as you just said, I am here with Wonder.